Let's roll sound, roll cameras.
203, take one.
What was your favorite theater production growing up, and why?
I think you know that answer already.
Not on camera, I don't.
I saw the national tour of Cats when I was 9 years old, and I thought it was so cool because the cats came down through the aisles, and then they had these like green eyes, and then a spaceship went off, and that was all just the opening of the show. Yeah, I think Cats now and forever.
I didn't grow up with musicals, so like my favorite musical theater star was probably Zero Mostel, because my mom loved Fiddler on the Roof and we listened to that album constantly, so maybe the only musical I knew anything about was Fiddler on the Roof.
Interesting. Any parallels to Snowpiercer?
We could sing that in the tale.
Yeah, right?
It's the ghetto.
Have you seen a clone of yourself on tour?
We've talked about this difference between sort of the musical theater world and the straight play world, is that like plays are supposed to be different every time you see them. And with a musical, there's this weird thing of once it's on Broadway, you're supposed to lock that and then ship that all across the world, which makes no sense.
Clones.
I don't understand it. Yeah.
Clone productions everywhere.
I've loved watching all of the Jefferson Lafayettes.
It was so tailored to you, specific, and you guys built the show. That was my audition for Hedwig and the Angry Inch. I had to play a man. I knew the show really well, and I really wanted the job. And the role is a man who becomes this beautiful drag queen at the end. But the last audition, John Cameron Mitchell wanted me to be in character the entire time I was in the room and tell a joke in character. I basically wrote an entire 2.5-minute monologue.
You didn't want to just tell a knock-knock joke.
No. I wanted them to just undeniably be like, I guess we have to give her the job.
The only like warm-up I ever learned was when I was running track. When I'm in the theater, I'm like doing high knees up and down the aisles. It's the only thing I know that symbolizes warming up to me. So I'd be very like physically ready to perform, and vocally and mentally, I'm still a mess. The first time they had me touch Hamilton, everyone's warming up. like all this shit. I was just watch them and kind of be like, trying to pretend like
running
I knew.
Around doing
yeah,
your knees.
Yeah, like, all right, no burpees, huh? Okay, come on, I'll do it your way. Don't miss new episodes of Snowpiercer on TNT. And watch on demand anytime on the TNT app.
Hey, it's Lisa. Stay with me for more on TV. Now, if you love your TV shows, here are 5 suggestions for series to binge watch. Parks and Recreation on Netflix, Buffy the Vampire Slayer on Hulu, Westworld on HBO, Orphan Black on Amazon Prime, The Wire on HBO and Amazon Prime. Now, what's your favorite series to binge watch? And also, do you like my shirt? You can get one for yourself in the link in the description.